Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, I show you how to subtract fractions that have a common denominator, and we do these six problems. Here's our first problem, 8/13 minus 3/13. So we're subtracting fractions that have a common denominator. The rule is the same as it is for addition. In order to subtract fractions, you have to have a common denominator, and you write down the denominator, right? Because then we could just subtract the numerators, 8 minus 3, which we usually do in our head, of course, to get 5/13. You know, pretend like when you say 8/13, think of it as a thing. Like you have five of those, eight of those things, minus three of those things, you're going to end up with five of those things. Those things in this case happens to be 13ths. All right, so let's do another problem. How about 5/6 minus 1/6? So again, we're subtracting fractions and we have a common denominator, so we can go ahead and write the denominator down and subtract the numerator. So let's do that in our head. 5 minus 1 is 4. Right now we need to reduce that. So you have to think what number goes into both 4 and 6, or you could prime factor it. And 2 goes into both of those since it's even. You don't need to write that out, but I'm just showing you what I'm doing. So my answer will be 2/3. So it's really very similar to subtracting, to adding fractions. You just get a common denominator and you subtract the numerators instead of add the numerators. So here's one for you to try. So put the video on pause, try this problem, and simplify it. All right, we've got 4/15 minus 1/15, so that will be 3/15. And that reduces to 1/5. How'd I get that? I divided the top and bottom by 3. I divided that by 3, both the numerator and denominator by 3, to get 1/5. So really, that's all there is to do if you have two fractions, proper fractions especially, and you're subtracting. If you've got a common denominator, you write the denominator down, and then subtract the numerators, and then reduce it if you can. All right, what if you had some mixed numbers that you were subtracting? If you have a common denominator, then all you need to do is subtract the whole numbers. 5 minus 3 is 2, and then subtract the two fractions. So 7/10 minus 1/10 has a common denominator of 10, and we do 7 minus 1 is 6. Now, this is not reduced. So now I need to reduce 6/10. And it's even, so you could divide the numerator and denominator by 2. So that'll give you 2 and 3/5 for your final answer. Now you could also do this problem by rewriting each of these numbers as improper fractions. So 5/7 minus 3/1. Another way of doing this is to write each of them with a common denominator. So that will give me 10 times 5 is 50 plus 7. So that would be 57/10. And 10 times 3 is 30 plus 1 is 31/10. And then you could subtract, and that'll give you 46/10. Now, 46/10 is an improper fraction and it's not reduced. So you need to at least reduce it. So you could either change it to a mixed number and reduce it, or you could reduce it and change it to a mixed number. Either way will work. Let's say you reduce it first. So I divide the top and bottom by 2. That'll give you 23/5. And that is a perfectly legitimate answer. Or if you want to write it as a mixed number by doing 23 divided by 5, you'll get 2 3/5. So here's a problem for you to try. So go ahead and put the video on pause and try this problem. All right, so I have 9 minus 2, and I also have 11 twelfths minus 5 twelfths. So both of those are simple to do. 9 minus 2 is 7, and 11 twelfths minus 5 twelfths is 6 twelfths. So now all I need to do is reduce this 6 twelfths and get 7 and a half. Now, of course, you could also do it that other way I showed you, by rewriting each of these as improper fractions, but that's really more work because this is pretty simple. But if the problem had been turned around and I had something like 9 and 5 twelfths minus 2 and 11 twelfths, notice I've changed the fractions. This is where we have a little bit of a difficulty. And I show you how to do this on another video, okay? But you can also just change these to the improper fractions and you'll get your answer. But I show you a couple different ways of doing a problem like this, where if you have 5 minus 11, there's a problem here. So if it's simple to subtract, like we have 11 twelfths minus 5 twelfths, 11 minus 5, you can go ahead and do that subtraction. It's simpler to just subtract the whole numbers and then to subtract the fractions. So here's a little preview of how you could do that. You could change each of these to improper fractions, and at least they have a common denominator. So we have 12 times 9, that's 108, plus 5 is 113. So you have to do that multiplication and addition, and then we're going to subtract. 12 times 2, 24, plus 11 is 35. Remember, you don't do 12 times negative 2. That's just this minus sign out over here. So then we have to do 113 minus 35 because we already have a common denominator of 12. Let's see, what's that? It's going to be 8, 6, 7, 8 twelfths. And then we need to reduce that. All right, so let's take 78 twelfths. So you might not know what number goes into the biggest number that goes into there, but you could certainly see they're both even, so we could divide each of them by 2. To begin with, that's 39 sixths. And then actually, 3 goes into both of these numbers, so you can divide again. 39 divided by 3 is 13, and 6 divided by 3 is 2. So that's 13 halves, or 6 and a half if you change it to a mixed number. And does that seem reasonable? 9 and 5 twelfths minus 2 and 11 twelfths. Notice that's like a little bigger than 9, and this is almost 3. Okay? So this is like about 9 and a half minus 3. Well, yeah, that seems about 6 and a half. So that answer does seem reasonable. But we'll do more problems like this on the video on subtracting. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.